Well, thanks for watching another episode of Revelations. I'm Pastor Chuck Reisch, the show host and executive producer. This is a series all about evangelism and discipleship. We're hoping you, our viewers, would get a couple revelations. One, God is still working. And two, there's a part for you to be playing in the body of Christ. Today we're in Guatemala City, visiting the Christian Academy of Guatemala. And with me is Dr. Stan Herod, who's the director of the school. Dr. Herod, thank you so much for letting us join you guys this week. We've been having a blast.
Well, it's great to have you here, Chuck. We've had a good time, too.
Yeah, your team is amazing, and I was hoping you could tell our viewers a little bit about the history and how the school started, and more importantly, why.
Well, the school started, its inception was 1974. It came about as a result of missionaries who, actually, in this context, there was no English-speaking curriculum for kids that are the children of missionaries, so that they could be prepared to go back, usually to the home country of the North American missionaries.
Yeah.
So the missionary community has been very strong since that time.
We'll talk about the multiculture that exists here and how that plays out in the school as well.
Of course, the country is about 50% Mayan Indian. There's 23 different language groups and many more dialects in addition to those language groups, and they're very distinct. They're Mayan languages, but they're very distinct one from another. Mm-hmm. The other part of the population is a mixture of both Spanish and the native Mayan, which we call Ladino. Many other countries are now sending missionaries to Guatemala, not just North America. So we have many Koreans, we have South Americans, we have people from New Zealand, South Africa, Europe. So that impacts our student population as well because of the many different missionary groups or ethnic groups that are coming in to minister here in Guatemala.
It's a real melting pot of missionaries.
It is, and it's just great to see how the community, the school community, absorbs and those diverse, not just linguistic differences, but also cultural differences, and it becomes one family, which is what it's supposed to be because, you know, we have the same father.
Yeah.
And so it really makes it, it's a very sweet, wonderful thing to watch the kids play together, not knowing that they're actually from Korea or from Guatemala or from Costa Rica or Iowa. And so it's very special.
Very good. Hey, stay tuned. We're going to get some more interviews and hear about the vision, the mission, and the heartbeat of the Christian Academy of Guatemala. So hopefully you get a couple of revelations and hear that calling to come help.
I think the vision and the heartbeat of Christian Academy of Guatemala is to train leaders in the ministry, not only in ministry, but when they go out into the secular world to influence this world for Christ and to be a positive influence to show the unbelieving world the difference between Christianity and other religions and other beliefs.
The heartbeat of the school is love, service, just God's grace and caring.
To equip and raise them up to serve the Lord from where they are or wherever they end up. That's the ministry of this school, and it has been in our family.
Well, that's the purpose of our school, is to be able to provide that education for their children to allow them to continue to work and do the ministry God's called them to do in Guatemala.
It's enabled us to be free to keep doing ministry and know that our kids by having their needs met academically, socially, having friends.
Biggest concerns that I had before coming to the mission field was how were my children going to be taken care of? How are they going to be brought up so that they could function well in whatever society they decide to go to? He's equipping them for that through CAG.
We try to equip our students with our Bible classes
and all our curriculum. Also, we have discipleship groups. We have servant days where we go out and do projects in the community in different places.
We want students to not only understand Christ, but we want them to experience Christ in their work, in their service, on the soccer field, you know, in the choir, or wherever that's going to be.
We really want them to be prepared academically in order to receive the education they need in order to continue to serve the Lord in whatever area He may call them to. But at the same time, making sure that they really do have that personal relationship with the Lord so that they won't fall away from Him later on.
If you don't have that Christian belief and that just that saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, you can be lots of things on the outside, but it's not going to last. And that's something that I see CAG really focusing on, is nourishing from the inside.
One of the blessings about working at Christian Academy of Guatemala is the opportunity to be involved with a lot of the different ministries going on around the country, to get to know the missionaries doing different things and be a little part of those different ministries.
They come as a social work. They come to help in orphanages or shelters for women. So we have all those different kinds of missionaries here at school. And our school encourages the children of those families.
Teachers that care about me, and it's just an environment that I want to be in, that I like being in, and that I'm so grateful that I'm a part of it.
So yeah. The school has been a blessing to us, and especially to their spiritual life and their academic life is amazing.
We could come to Guatemala, we could minister where God is calling us, but at the same time our kids wouldn't be falling in the cracks and not getting the education they need.
I like the fact that it's small and family oriented, because we're Christian based and we could use that for God's glory. And so I feel like it's very important. Education is significant in everyone's lives and it can change a lot of things.
Believe, you know, God has given us this vision, and we're just happy that we are able to be part of His work so that we could continue to equip the leaders of Guatemala.
If you know of a ministry that we need to know about, please give us a call, 888-641-8606, or take a look at our website, revelationstv.org. Well, thanks for continuing to watch this episode of Revelations. We're in Guatemala City visiting the Christian Academy of Guatemala. With me is the director, Dr. Stan Herrod. So Dr. Herrod, talk about evangelism. How is the Lord using ministry to help share the gospel from here?
Well, Chuck, from the very beginning, the school's mission was to provide an education where the parents, the missionary parents, would feel comfortable with the educational package that we could provide for their children, which frees them not to have to homeschool, not to have to send their kids off to boarding school, but frees them to actually do their ministry. Now, we have had over the years more than 50 different denominational or mission organizations represented within our association.
Wow.
And doing anything from church planting, evangelistic crusades, Bible translation, just about every kind of mission activity you could possibly think of,
right,
our missionaries or our parents do.
One of the things we heard in our interviews while we're here is, even from the students, their faith became their own. You know, again, they're riding on the coattails of their parents who have heard the call, that are in ministry.
Yes.
And you just assume the kids are Christian because they came out the womb that way. But there comes a time when the children have to own it and receive it and walk it and live it. So you guys see that happen probably throughout the year, I'd imagine.
Our teachers are missionaries. They raise their own support. They associate with a mission board or a church, a local church in the States or in Korea or South Africa, wherever they're from. And so their commitment is, I think, they don't approach it as if it were a job. They approach it as if it's a ministry. So the children benefit from that commitment. And the testimony we get from alumni all the time is, it's not about the campus, it's not about the great programs, but it's about the people, the teachers. They say, the teachers, I have the best teachers in the world, they love me, you know, we're still friends, they still care about what I do. And so that really is a unique ingredient, I think, that we can provide and that makes us unique.
Amen. Stay tuned. We're going to get some more interviews and talk a little bit about evangelism and sharing the gospel, living the gospel in word and deed here at the Christian Academy of Guatemala.
God is using this school in a mighty way to reach the world and to share the gospel. Just here in the community and people being sent out from here.
We have had opportunities where kids have been able to participate in visiting orphanages and different ministries around the area. And we are able to share those ideas and what observations the kids saw in class.
Plus, chapels cannot be understated, the importance of their chapel times and the excellent chaplaincy program that the school has.
In everything we do, we really try to glorify God with our actions. We've got some incredible kids with incredible gifts, and it's part of our role to help give those kids an opportunity to develop those gifts.
Kids grow up with multi-language classrooms, multi-cultured work groups. So they are, the world is smaller for them. So when they graduate from school, they're not thinking, well, I'm just gonna go to this state or this college or this community or this area. They're not thinking about one country or even two or three countries. They're just thinking as a world, as a place where they can outreach. And that takes away a lot of the fear.
Then you get to know the culture, you get to know the people, you get to know their heart, and you get to see what God's doing. What God is doing in Guatemala is just fantastic.
Especially this year, we focused on kingdom loving and actually asking students if they understand the gospel message and then challenging them to share that where they're at right now, to find their purpose in the middle of the circumstances that God has them right now in their lives.
Not just having love, but being loving and reaching out to other people. And that's basically what we've been taught to do, is that when we go out there, it's not about us, it's about others, and it's about showing love to them, showing Christ.
I'll tell you, the school when I first came was just a huge blessing. I mean, they really served and helped us as a missionary family to feel welcome. And we have our children here in the school, and the Discovery Program is a huge blessing for one of our children.
And the administration always is just committed to meeting those needs and making sure that teachers and parents are on board and that student receives the intervention they need.
It really is true that we all, as far as faculty and staff, feel like we're equipping the next generation for bearing the gospel into the world.
They're there because God has called them and because they love kids, and they want to see the kids know that they are special and that they are loved because of who they are and not because of what their parents do.
Some of our students have played with the national soccer team in Guatemala, which is a really big deal because soccer is a big thing in South America and Central America. So our students are not only involved only in CAG, but they go out in the community and do different things.
Not only are they from different places in the world, but they're going to be sent out to different places because these are third culture kids. They understand.
Christian Academy of Guatemala students, they come to our school. And students, they have our English class. So we are very much have a benefit through the CAG.
If you know of a ministry that we need to know about, please give us a call, 888-641-8606, or take a look at our website, revelationstv.org. Well, thanks for continuing to watch this episode of Revelations. We're at the Christian Academy of Guatemala here in Guatemala City. With me is Dr. Stan Herod, and we're talking about discipleship. And I've asked everybody on staff, the teachers and the students, what does discipleship mean here?
we are trying to help the student gain a Christian worldview.
Yeah.
And so discipleship goes on in every activity,
right.
Whether it's, nothing is just academic and nothing is just sports. Everything is based foundational on the Word of God and who God is and who we are in relation to God and what God expects for us,
yeah.
How we perform, how we express ourselves, how we express our love for God, whether it's we're writing out a math formula or drawing a picture or playing the violin.
Right.
It's all part of the same ball of wax.
Yeah, while we're doing our tour and getting some B-roll, we saw the math and the science, and then we saw some basketball players, and in the background, they were changing attire in a Christian worldview. That's amazing.
That's right. That's what we do here.
it really is holistic, and that's what I saw right away. It's not just Bible class and another Bible class. It's everything through a Christian worldview.
So what we want to do is to help our students become the person, not the academician and not the student that God wants them to be, but the person that God wants them to be. And it's not all about academic excellence. It's about being a man or a woman of God. And for that to go beyond their time in Guatemala or at CAG, something that we hope will become part of who they are, and they will go on to continue to develop and affect other people,
right.
And be mentors and be disciplers, whether it's with the people they are with at work or school or their families.
Yeah.
And what has been great is that now we have children of the children, that went to school with my children coming to CAG,
yeah.
Because that's where they want them.
Right.
Because it was such a positive experience. Now we have children of our alumni who are in our school.
That's good. Hey, stay tuned. We're going to talk a little bit more about discipleship and how that is just lived out. It's a 24-hour thing, following Jesus and learning how to walk in His ways.
All of our academics are taught through a Christian worldview, whether it's the sciences, math, English, they're all tied in some way to God and His purpose and how we can fulfill that.
And it's just wonderful to see our children wanting to serve and just really loving to serve. It's very important to share what we do here and the vision of helping lead children to do a work for Christ and go out in the world and be disciples for Christ.
Nourishing a student from the inside out so that they learn God's word and they learn what it means to obey that word and not to just put on a facade, which in a Christian environment can happen at times.
They are missionary kids. Their identity is in that, in the fact that they can just relax and know that they're just growing up in God in a Christian environment where they can just really feel like they really belong. And that's been a real key thing.
As a discovery therapist, I see missionary families that come to Guatemala and they find out that there is a discovery program here at our school. And they are so excited to be able to enroll their children into this program and see them flourish and make gains and just do so successfully here at the school.
Discipleship is CAG. Discipleship is an everyday thing, an every minute thing here at CAG.
Spiritually and physically and emotionally, you can grow so much better than just going to church once a week.
They don't see their students only as students, but they also see them as disciples, and how everything they do, everything they say, should have a spiritual impact to their growth.
But it gives us a chance to teach our kids, this is how you do life in Christ. Not just tell them, but teach them.
I have seen teachers involved in the lives of our kids and really care really caring about them, about their spiritual growth and social growth and in every area of their lives.
He thought, I'm gonna teach my kids to serve, and he found that his heart changed while being at CAG.
Discipleship here is showing the children how to live as Jesus did. And we make mistakes, and even through those mistakes, we teach the children it's okay to make a mistake as long as you have the right mentality and go from there. And you know, God will pick you up, and God will guide you step by step.
If you know of a ministry that we need to know about, please give us a call, 888-641-8606, or take a look at our website, revelationstv.org. Thanks again for continuing to watch this episode of Revelations. We're hoping by now you've had a few. God is still working, and there is a part for you to be playing, especially in Christian education and especially on the mission field here in Guatemala. With me is Dr. Stan Herod from the Christian Academy of Guatemala. How can the church get involved and support a frontline ministry like this?
We would ask people to pray for us, to pray for the school, pray for the students, for the faculty, for the staff, for the parents who are involved in ministry, because it's all one unit. Our teachers are supported financially as missionaries. We don't pay our missionary teachers' salaries.
They're distinctive. I mean, most Christian education is tuition-driven and teacher salaries. So
that's right. And one of the reasons for that is it makes it affordable for our missionaries who are not overly financed in most cases. And it makes it, we offer a reasonable tuition cost that goes to our buildings and to our maintenance. Everything that you would associate with any school, and you know, position-wise, we have those positions. Librarians, music teachers, PE teachers, you know, whatever you have studied and whatever you have learned to do, you can bring that to the Christian Academy, and we will welcome you with open arms.
Amen. And in the process, they're building up the next generation of world changers and disciple makers.
That's right. We have we've been able to develop world changers. God has done that through the efforts of Christian Academy of Life.
Amen. Well, keep watching, hoping by now you'd hear a little tug from the Holy Spirit to get involved with the Christian Academy of Guatemala.
Christians can support CAG by sending missionaries to come to Guatemala, not only to have their kids here at our school, but also maybe to support a teacher that could come.
We are here to keep missionaries on the field. You can check out the school website, www.christacadguate.org. You can go to that website, you can find job positions, missionaries, you can contact people.
I think churches today could offer a huge amount of support to us through prayer, primarily. Also, just interaction with teams that could come down and get to know us and our kids that we teach here, building relationships and contacts for the future.
Start at CAG even, and have an opportunity to serve there while you kind of get your toes wet in other ministry or see what other ministry might be out there.
Well, one way would be to support a teacher who comes to teach here, because we do not receive a salary and we are living on the offerings that people give.
And if you're looking for a missionary opportunity and a place to pour into to lives of kids that desperately need it, CAG is a place for you.
And I know we're always seeking for teachers in the higher level education. And so we need teachers qualify, and the teachers with a heart to get involved with missionary kids and their education.
God will use you wherever He puts you, but you don't have to have special skills just to come and do here at CAG.
We can be involved. CAG is a place where we encourage the involvement of the parents.
I just think that it's just a blessing to be here in Guatemala to serve the Lord at Christian Academy of Guatemala, and to have this opportunity to invest our lives into these students.
If you are here on a short-term mission trip, you might be able to come help by volunteering and serving and just seeing our campus and seeing our kids.
We're always struggling for faculty and staff, so why not? Why not come and be a part of that?
just seeing the student body transform through the spirit was amazing. Me as the president of the student body, and I hope for your prayer.
And missionaries need your prayers, and they need your support, and they need to know that you are there with them, that they are not alone in what God's called them to do.
I would challenge them to come down and spend a week with us. Check us out. Lots of opportunities. No matter what your role is, if you're a teacher, if you're a professional, there's a place on the wall for you at the Christian Academy.
And we want CAG to be a home and a shelter for all those that are just giving all the time.
And we just appreciate those that can contribute to either the Missionary Kids School or to the individual ministries, to just give with all your heart, because all of these people have really truly given all their heart to the Lord in every aspect of service and deed.
Well, I want to thank our viewers one last time for watching this episode of Revelations. And Dr. Herod, thank you for letting us spend a week with you guys. It's going to be hard to leave tomorrow, that's for sure.
Well, it's been great. I know you've gone to a lot of places and seen a lot of the ministry that our parents are involved in, and talked to our students and our faculty. And I know they've been excited all week to participate and to watch the filming. Some of our little kids in elementary want to play with the cameras and everything. So, I mean, it's truly been a great experience for us to have you on campus. And I know it's this whole project is going to make a difference in the future for our school.
Amen to that. Well, let's pray together. Let's ask our viewers to pray with us and see how God might move and form some new partnerships in the body. Father in heaven, Lord Jesus, Holy Spirit, you are awesome. And we thank you for the Christian Academy of Guatemala. I thank you so much for Stan and Linda and their answering the call to come and to establish a school that not only helps support the missionaries in the field, but builds up their children for Christian service and demonstrates this gospel in word and deed. And Lord, with the 10 or 11 million souls that are still in Guatemala, we know there's many that need to be saved and have their names written in the Lamb's Book of Life. So we pray in one accord with the church with us that those would answer the call to come and be missionaries and to offer their time, their treasure, and their talents to this great mission field. And pray that you would lead, guide, and direct that and those partnerships that are to come. And we pray for all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Well, again, thanks for watching this episode of Revelations. And until our next episode, may you and your families be blessed.